delighted today. My guest is Tatiana Lisnic, who is singing the role of Adina in Donizetti's The Elixir of Love for us.
Yes.
Tatiana, welcome.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
I am so delighted that we're presenting you because this is auspicious. This is your first appearance in the United States.
My very first appearance, yes.
So almost all of your singing has been in Europe?
Yes, and overseas on the other side.
The other side.
Tokyo, Seoul.
Oh, that other... over there.
Okay,
so you've been singing in Asia as well.
Yes, in Asia as well.
But just not here. That's wonderful, though. That's terrific. I noticed that some of your roles, certainly you've sung Adina a number
many
of times.
Yes.
Norina in
Norina
Don Pasquale.
As well, yes.
And La Traviata.
I did.
Which is a little heavier.
Yes, but... you know, our voice is not like we are the voice is changing, but we are growing. So the voice is more mature.
Uh-huh.
The certain maturity you can start heavier repertoire.
Mm-hmm.
Like Adina is very beginning.
Yeah.
Adina Norina is very light, soprano leggero.
Yeah.
And Traviata is lirico.
So Traviata, did you add that more recently? Within just the last couple of years, maybe, or
yes, a last couple of years ago, yes, and I'm not singing Violetta very often.
Yeah,
because it takes a lot of emotional.
And it's for three sopranos, right?
Yes. No,
it grows,
but it grows. It's true that it's one of the most difficult roles to interpret and to sing because the first act aria Estrano. It's a firework.
yeah, absolutely. Yes. Well, now, what of these roles that you sing, of all the roles that you sing, what is your favorite? What do you look forward to singing more than other roles?
Well, always my favorite is the role that I sing in that time.
At that time, yeah.
But I can't really pick a role. I love all the roles that I sing. I sing Mozart as well as I sing Donizetti or Verdi.
Oh.
I didn't sing early Verdi, though.
Well, that's for a very different soprano,
yes,
I think.
Yes. But I like Mozart the same I like the French repertoire, and the same I like the Italian repertoire. I just love singing.
What is it that about singing that drew you to it in the beginning? That made you want to be a singer more than anything else?
Yes, first of all, when I first heard the opera, entire opera, it was in my country on the radio.
In Romania?
In Moldova. Born in Moldova, yes. And we had a Moldavian singer, Maria Vieshu. She was singing Madama Butterfly.
Mm-hmm.
And what was for me like a magnet, it was the sound of the voice. This high, very, very, very angelic and very pure singing, for me was like heaven. I just felt a vibration in me, and that was my dream from then.
Were you very young?
Yes, I was. I was like 10.
Oh my gosh!
Yes, that was my dream. I didn't try to sing. I was singing in school all kind of songs, what we usually do in school, all kind of concerts and folk music. But then later, I was trying to imitate.
Oh.
Yes.
So when did you start studying? How old were you?
I start with 14.
Yeah.
Study in a musical gymnasium in Chisinau. That's the capital of Moldova. And I started to study as a choir director because it would be the only way to learn canto, because they had a facultative canto. So I was then the second year I switched to canto full time.
So you were watching the beats and
yes.
How to do three, how to do four,
a tempo di valsa, yes.
This role, Adina. Who is Adina? How do you see this character?
Well, she's a woman, first of all. She's a very, very...
This is not a trouser role.
She's a very... No. She's a very sparkling girl, because she's very girlish, especially when she teases Nemorino. It's very clear that is in love. She doesn't want to recognize that at the beginning. It's very conflictual.
She resists this.
Yes, she resists because she likes to play. She plays till a very dangerous moment when she really says yes to Belcore, that yes, I'll marry you in 6 days. Then she's kind of surprised of herself how far she goes. But I love Adina because she's never boring.
Yeah.
The music is beautiful.
Oh, it's gorgeous.
I won't say it's a comedy. It's more melodramatic. And the duets between them two are so beautiful, and the tempis, the changes, all the time going and coming from both of them. And the most beautiful moment for me in the end is the small recitativo before the aria Prendi.
Yeah.
It's when they really get to know, to say something very honest and very from deep coming emotionally. And even then, she doesn't say, I love you so much, I'd love to be with you. And she says, I did this and I did that. She expects him to come first. Then she, with these fireworks, coloraturas at the end, she tells him. That's beautiful.
Tell me, singing bel canto repertoire, you know, in music school, we're told, you know, it's all about the voice and a very simple accompaniment. But the more I study bel canto opera, it's really about the words, is it not? That the composers, this is one of the things that I try to communicate to our audiences, is that the composer is really trying to communicate the text.
Yes.
Do you find this true as a singer, that you put inside of the words, inside of the text?
There is no music, or if it's not the passion of the words which is telling you how to colorate the line, the melody, which are beautiful, obviously, but it can be very boring if it's just singing some words, if you do not give the right expression, the right vibration to the sound of tamo, or there are a lot of words that we can give as an example, but it's definitely voice emotion in the words, in between the words.
Yeah, exactly.
And
so you probably spend a lot of time
to find the character,
to find the right color as well in the the line.
And it's amazing because every time when I sing, even if I have a show, a group of shows like 3 or 4 or 5, it's always growing from the first time, because obviously we sing the character for many times, but it comes in different mise-en-scène and different.
Every performance is different.
Yes, but in every performance, even if you have a different feedback from your colleagues, it will change your mind, it will change your color, it will change. It's the way you feel in this day, you know, because every day we feel differently, every day we say the same expression with another, you know, sarcastic or ironic or whatever you find in this moment, you know.
Yeah.
So that's the beauty about this, our work.
Yeah. Well,
it's spontaneous.
Yes. Absolutely spontaneous. And I think that's what makes comedy work, too.
Yes.
So, so well. Because tragedy, as they say, is easy. Comedy, the timing has to be
there, yes.
Yeah. And yet you have to communicate to the audience that spontaneous nature, you know, that it's happening right at that moment.
Exactly. Well, that's the sparkle of it.
I had the joy of watching you in rehearsal today, and I can already tell it's going to sparkle. It's going to be such a charming show.
I love it. It's just have fun. It's very nice. And we have a traditional, beautiful production, and I'm very happy about it.
Yeah.
And beautiful colleagues as well.
Well, we're looking forward to it. Thank you so much for spending some time.
Thank you as well. Okay. Thank you.